of what was accomplished during the day. What should have been accomplished? How much was accomplished? Was what we accomplished proper? Did we do enough? Did we not do enough? And the Rebbe tells Rabbi Yechanan, did you know something? Every night, when I make this chesed ha-nefesh, I say to myself, that's all you did. Why didn't you do any more? Now let me give you a little description of the Rebbe's schedule, a daily schedule. The Rebbe worked literally, without exaggeration, 18 hours a day. And we could be a witness to it. The Rebbe would come to his office normally between 10 and 10:30. He would go home in the evening. In the winter, go home at 4 o'clock, and in summer, 7 o'clock. He'd always make sure to have dinner together with his wife, the Rebbe. They would both sit together and have dinner. After the Rebbe had his dinner, he would return to his office. A regular night, what I mean a regular night is, I'll soon tell you, the Rebbe would first go home between 1 to 2 o'clock in the morning. But the Rebbe did not go home empty-handed. The Rebbe went home with homework. The Rebbe would take a bag like this, as some people over here that maybe still remember, when the Rebbe walked out of his office 2 o'clock in the morning, he had a bag like this with all the mail that he did not have the opportunity to respond to look after during the day, he would take that home. When he came back the next morning, we would already have a pack of answers that the Rebbe wrote through the night. But the days when the Rebbe would receive people on a personal basis, which we call in our language yechidus, an interview, a personal interview with the Rebbe. So for the first 15 years, the Rebbe would receive people 3 times a week, Sunday, Tuesday, and Thursday. The Rebbe would never finish those evenings before 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning, but he still came 10 o'clock to the office. After 1965, the Rebbe only saw people twice a week. And the Rebbe would go home and come back the next morning again with work. The Rebbe, since he became a Rebbe in 1951, never took one day vacation. He was the chairman executive officer of one of the largest institutions. He never took one day vacation. The Rebbe told the office that he's available 24/7. When I say 24/7, I mean it literally. That even after the Rebbe left his office, he went home. And the Rebbe told us if an emergency arises where you have to have my advice, you need my bracha, my blessing, it could be 3 o'clock in the morning, 5 o'clock in the morning, you could call my home, you give me the information, and I'll give you the answer. And I can tell you from personal experience that not once did I have to call the Rebbe in the middle of the night, 3, 4 o'clock, when I excuse myself that I'm calling 4 o'clock in the morning, she said, what are you excusing yourself? Weren't you told that we're available 24 hours? We're available 24 hours. When I say 7 days a week, on Shabbos, on Yom Tov, on Rosh Hashanah, on Yom HaKippur, the Rebbe told us that I'm available. I once was speaking for a group of 50 business people. When I mentioned that the Rebbe was available on Shabbos and Yom Tov, one of them raised his hand, Rabbi Groner. I thought the Rebbe was a Shabbos observant Jew. How can he be in his office on Shabbos and Yom Tov? What are you telling me about Shabbos and Yom Tov as well? I said, you know, you may be right, but let me explain to you what type of office the Rebbe had. And after I explain that to you, tell me whether your question is still valid. I said, the Rebbe did not have a stock exchange office. The Rebbe did not have a business office. The Rebbe's office was a business, an office that had to do mainly with spiritual division. Which means to say, in his office the Rebbe would pray, he would study. That was an office from which light came out to the entire world. When the Rebbe gave instructions to people all over the world about different conducts and behaviors, that was a room where the Rebbe made people happy by giving them his advice and his blessings. That was a different type of office. And therefore the Rebbe said there is no Shabbos, an emergency arises. And you must have my bracha and my consent, I'm available. I am giver. When we have the intermission between the Mincha service and the Neva service, I'm in my office, you're allowed to come in. After the Rebbe was a Rebbe for about 15 years and working on this type of schedule, the secretaries had a meeting. And we decided that we have to offer the Rebbe to take a vacation for 2-3 weeks. We had somebody go down to Montauk, that's the end of Long Island. We found a secluded place, and we decided that we're going to suggest to the Rebbe that the Rebbe should take a vacation at that secluded place. We will have a meeting 3 times a day for the Rebbe, but there will be no telephones. We won't bring the Rebbe any mail to give him a rest from the burdens, from the loads that he has on his head. For 2-3 weeks, he should be removed from all that, be able to take it easy, do all the study what he wants without interruptions. So we asked one of the elder secretaries that they should go into the Rebbe and propose this suggestion. He comes out and he tells them that the Rebbe listened, and the Rebbe said, I'm very thankful that you people are thinking about me, about my health, what I have to do. But let's play this out, he says. You say that for 2-3 weeks, I'm going to be secluded, no telephones, no mail. Now you get a telephone call in the office, back in front eyes, that there's an individual that's very, very sick. And the doctors decided that within the next 24 hours, in order to save his life, he has to have an operation. And without my consent and blessing, he's not going to do it. They call the office, and you tell them, well, we're sorry, we cannot contact the Rebbe for the next 2-3 weeks. Then a young couple, a boy and girl, one who gets engaged, they tell you, you have to put it off for 2-3 weeks. The person who wants to do a business sale, and without my advice, is not going to do it, because he saw the deal when we just saw it, they push everything off for 2-3 weeks. Then the Rebbe says, let me ask you a more simple question. How many pieces of mail do you people bring into my office every day, averagely? I'm not speaking about notes that come from the telephone or people bring. What does the mailman bring into the office? Sacks. So the secretary told between 250 and 300 pieces of mail, which is not exaggeration, because I used to take in the mail, so I know what it was. Now the Rebbe says, let's say for 2 weeks I'm going to be away on vacation. For 2 weeks you're not going to bring me the mail. When I come back after the 2 weeks, okay, let's be conservative. Less time is 250 times 14. How many thousands of pieces of mail is that? I'm going to come back after the 2 weeks. You're going to bring into me all those sacks of mail, and you're going to tell me, you know, people are waiting for answers. And the Rebbe gives him a big smile, and he says, tell me, this is what you call vacation. So here you have an individual that never took a day vacation, works 18 hours a day, literally, is available 24/7, and he tells this Rabbi Yehuda, take a lesson from me. But every night, after I make my Cheshbon Nefesh, I make my account of what I accomplished, I say to myself, that's all he did. But what could you do? At 19 hours, not even to rest 4 hours. What did the Rebbe say? And the Rebbe explains to this Rabbi Yehuda, whenever a person has the opportunity to add just a little bit more, he shouldn't say to himself, I did so much today, I'll take a rest. If Hashem presents to you an opportunity to do that day something more, then Hashem knows how much you did till now. That means Hashem feels that you have the ability and you can do that extra little bit. And you never know how that extra little bit could be more important than everything that you did in the course of the day. And this is what the Rebbe teaches us. The Rebbe teaches us that we should know we constantly have to grow. We cannot be stagnant. We cannot remain on one level. The Rebbe says that each moment, each hour Hashem gives us, he wants that we should grow with that. We should elevate ourselves. And we should try to do more and more. And then the Rebbe tells him, my philosophy in life